Welcome to Christ the King, Healing on Tap.
How great the chasm.
We're very happy to receive today Father Joshua Grandmaison, who's going to be sharing a story of faith and how the Lord touched him.
In desperation, I turned to heaven and spoke your name.
Yeah, my name is Father Joshua Grandmaison. I'm a Companion of the Cross. I was ordained in the summer of 2022, so quite recently. And it's a great privilege and honor to be able to share what God has done in my life. I grew up in a very Catholic family, a cultural Catholic family. I have five brothers, three sisters, and my parents brought us to Mass every Sunday. We'd always pray grace before meals, and occasionally we'd even pray the rosary together as a family. But despite all these good things, I didn't really know the Lord personally. I knew that Jesus was God. I knew that in my mind. But I didn't have that peace and that consolation that comes from knowing the Lord personally. So in high school and junior high, even, I started to hang out with the people my parents told me not to. Started smoking marijuana on a regular basis, drinking quite heavily. I was pretty reckless, pretty careless. I didn't know what I wanted to do in life. You know, as going to church as a kid, sometimes you wonder, hey, maybe being a priest, or altar serving and stuff like that. But it never really crossed my mind more than anything. All I wanted to do was to be happy. And, looking for parties, going to parties and all that stuff. Those things of the world just made me more isolated, more depressed, and not happy. I got into several car accidents. My fourth car accident in 2007, after dropping out of college for going there for one semester. I dropped out because I was failing all my classes and stuff. Except for drawing. I love to draw. I'm a bit of an artist. But so I crashed my car, and I remember sitting there in the driver's seat. My car was total. I had wrapped it around a tree, and I just had a bruise on my leg. And I remember just looking at the crucifix hanging from the rearview mirror, right? That rosary. As a cultural Catholic, everybody has a rosary on their rearview mirror, even though I didn't pray it too often. I sense the Lord saying to me, Joshua, how much more suffering do you have to go through before you come to me? And I was just like, wow, I really need to change my life. And like they say, I was on my way nowhere real fast. I could have lost my life there. And so that night, I wanted to commit my life to the Lord. I knew you can sell your soul to the devil. So I was like, hey, I'm going to sell my soul to God. God, I want to belong to you 100%. So that night, I put the rosary around my neck. I poured out all my liquor. And I said, Lord, whatever you want me to do, I'm going to do it. But you have to help me. You have to give me the grace, because I can't do it alone. I've been trying to, be happy and live a holy life and stuff like that, but I just can't do it. So anyways, I spoke with my mom. She spoke with the parish priest, and he suggested that I go to Madonna House. I was living in Calabogie at the time. Madonna House is only like 2 hours away. So I went there, and I went there for a week just to thank God for having saved my life. And like, Lord, speak, your servant is listening, right? Lord, give me some direction. And I ended up going to confession. And in confession, that's where I really encountered the Lord in a personal, life-changing way. Because as I confessed my sins, everything that was on my heart, everything that was weighing me down, as I shared, it's just like a weight was coming off of me. And I started crying. And when the priest prayed over me, words can't express how I felt at that moment. It was like everything I longed for, everything I was desiring, right? This restless heart was being satisfied. I was filled with an immense joy. Like in the charismatic renewal, we would say that's a baptism of the Holy Spirit. I felt rejuvenated. I felt like a little kid again, like innocent. And I was like, wow, this is amazing. It's thanks to a priest I'm able to experience this. And I was like, well, I want to be a priest. I want everybody to know God's mercy, that he's real, that he takes away the sins of the world. It's not just something that we say at Mass. I didn't really know what it meant to be a priest. I didn't really know what it meant to live the Catholic faith. I was learning that when I went to Madonna House about the liturgical calendar, even though I was only there for a week, right? But it just changed my perspective on life. And like it says in St. Peter's letter, the dog returns to its vomit, the swine returns to the mire. No, my life wasn't changed completely for the better right away. It was the whole process. I fell miserably through my sin, but God in his mercy continued to call me and to put that call of the priesthood on my heart. I started helping out at my parish and stuff like that. And I just had a zeal for evangelizing, for telling people about how good God is, how merciful he is, and that he's real, and that, you know, as I was trying to live out the church's teaching more and more, I got more of that joy of the gospel, more, you know, more comfortable in my own skin, more confidence. And yeah, I wanted to learn more about my faith, because when I would evangelize, there was these really good questions of apologetics. And I was like, yeah, I really don't know. And I was discerning a call to religious life with Madonna House. I went to Madonna House in Edmonton. And then somebody had suggested, hey, maybe you should go to a faith formation school, like a Bible school. So I went to Sainte-Thérèse School of Faith and Mission. That's where I met the Companions of the Cross. Even though I was from Ottawa, I met them when I was out in Saskatchewan while they were doing missions there. So, yeah, I remember going to do 2 years there at that faith formation program, helping out in my parish. The first time I went to a Companions of the Cross parish was at St. Mary's on Divine Mercy Sunday. And I remember Father Roger Vandenacker at the time, who was pastor there, and he was just praising the Lord, and just an immense consolation came upon me when I was there. And yeah, just trying to do the next best thing and asking the Lord, hey, Lord, what are you calling me to? And the Lord has made it obvious that he's called me to the priesthood, and he's made it obvious by the laying on of hands from the bishop. So I'm grateful to be an ordained minister, to now be able to share God's mercy to fellow sinners in the confessional. It's just such an immense, awesome thing, right? It's you just can't comprehend God's mercy, right? He loves us. His God's ways are not our ways. We don't have to earn his love. He just loves us so much. And knowing that has spurred me on to want to serve the Lord, want to be like him more and more. I still have a long ways to go. I'm not where I would like to be. I'm probably not where God wants me to be. But by God's grace, I'm not where I used to be. So I hope that helps encourage you if you feel called to the priesthood, to pursue the Lord, to ask him, Lord, give me the grace, then show me what you want me to do. Or if you're a lay person, and hopefully this spurs you on to know that God loves you and he is very merciful.
How great the chasm that lay between us.
Thank you, Father Josh, for this so beautiful story where the Lord saved you, really did save you, and how I opened the Bible and I got Haggai chapter 2, and it talks about how the splendor of the new temple. And this is really like he took you out, he took you out of Egypt, and he brought you to the promised land. And now he's with you forever. He's within you, and he wants to partner with you so you can do the work. And it's actually written like, so that, you know, do not be discouraged, for I am with you. So I'll do the work with you. So I just bless you, bless your life with more of all of his gifts. There are peace, love, kindness, but also like the other gifts, you know, the prophetic gifts, the healing gifts, as you are called to do healing with the people that you will encounter. So I just praise the Lord, and I bless you with all of his joy and his love. In Jesus' name, I pray.
Amen. Well, thanks a lot, Marie Chantal.
You're welcome.
Beautiful
My
words.
Pleasure.
Through the darkness, your loving kindness tore through the shadows of my soul. The work is finished, the end is is written, Jesus Christ, my living hope. Who could